Has Tariq gone too far to make a change? Remember to vote above and let me know what you think. Is Tariq gone too far to change? He does have a little bit of Tasha as well as Ghost in him, but he has their good qualities. He was sheltered. Remember, him and Raina were sheltered. They didn't know nothing about the life until Kanan brought him into it. And Tariq has a moral compass. Shout out to Nelly Mac 91, who put a comment on one of my other videos about his moral compass. He's conflicted because he wasn't grown up all the way in the hood. He's just kind of dipped his toe into it and experienced the good part of hanging with the homeboys, smoking, drinking, getting a little booty with girls or whatever, but he ain't really about how dirty it can get. He had a taste when Sean died, but he didn't see it, you know. And now that he's older, he think he knows what it is. He think he about that life, but really he don't know what that life is like. And you know, Raina was talking about going to Choate, and he think it's all white people, this or that, and preppy, and he think he hood and gangster. He hitting up Brains, talking about, I want in, he want to hit a lick. This is a dude that lives in a penthouse, you know, that's probably $10,000 a month, and he want to rob somebody for a few, you know, $100, $1,000. Nevertheless, he goes in there, and this robbery, I think, really helped him realize who he is and who he's not. Unfortunately, it cost this woman her life. He told these guys, come in, he played the role. They came, pushed him to the side, played it off, but dude gave him a little uppercut in the ribs, and it really hurt him bad. I think that's the first time he may have even got hit. You know, Ghost had never showed him hit him. You know, Tasha ain't tried to hit him, and he blocked it. So he never really been hit by nobody, you know, and so that was his first time even getting popped. They told him to leave. He don't listen. He don't really know about that life. It's a number one rule. You never say somebody's name. When he saw the guy about to rape her, which that was kind of pathetic and disgusting that he was going to rape her, he screamed out the dude's name, Brains, tell her, let her go. Tell him, let her go. And right then he messed up. That's rule number one. You never say the person's name. It's actually his fault they had to kill her. Now, I'm not saying it's his fault, you know, that, you know, they bad dudes or whatever. They wouldn't have probably been able to rob that house without him, but they were looking for the trouble anyway. Nevertheless, by him saying the name, maybe she would have been raped and they would have let her live. Not saying that that's great, but she wouldn't have lost her life. And then she had to beg for her life because they already knew it was over with. They said the name, they have something to go off of, they don't want to go to jail, and so they killed her. And when he saw what was going down, it scared him to his core. He realized these dudes are really bad dudes. I thought that it was cool, hang with them, smoke, drink and lean, but actually these dudes are killers, they bad, and I'm not ready for that. I don't want to be a part of that. And he broke out, he ran. He ran for his life. He never ran so hard in his life. Look at him. He was shook. And he went to hide. He ran into the garbage can. You know, he was fumbling all over the place. And when he was leaning up in the wall trying to catch his breath and hide, they were texting him saying, hey, you know, where are you? Now, let me ask you guys this. Do you think they would have killed Tariq in there? Because they had killed the girl. You think dude would have just checked him, maybe smacked him up, threatened him, or do you think he would have just killed Tariq right there? That's a good question. I don't know myself. That's something I've been wondering. Maybe he would have killed Tariq, and that way there's no more witnesses. There's nothing to worry about. So maybe he did do good by running, you know, because they probably would have killed him. He ain't nobody to them. Now, by him running, they definitely probably will kill him. When he got home, he's trying to play the role. He's actually kind of zapped back into reality and want to be a good kid again because he knows that he ain't about that life. And when Ghost called him to introduce him to Alderman Tate, he was, you know, very humble and quiet. And, you know, he was trying to, you know, play the role, a good kid. And when he was walking away, he got a text, Brains are still looking for you, boy. And so he turned back around and said, you know what, let me get out of town. Let me go to Choate. He didn't want to tell his dad because he know his dad is going to be, you know, kind of pissed that he's about that lifestyle. He don't realize how deep Canaan got into his head, unfortunately. And so, Ghost, you know, for those that know about what happens in the leak, the reason what happened with his sister is because he was still hiding and running, you know, and she was trying to help him out, but she has no idea what this life is about, you know. And so I'm not going to say any more, but, you know, I think that may have pushed him all the way over the edge, but that still goes back to the original premise of this video. Do you think after that he can come back? You know, I don't know, man. He may be too gone. And if he's too gone, what will Ghost do? Will Ghost make him his number two man, raise him up and just say, all right, I'm gonna raise you up in this life under me, teach you how I do things, and you'll learn how to do things like your old man. I mean, once you go so far, it's hard to go back. So we'll see. It's probably going to happen in next season. So we all have to stay tuned to see how it goes with Tariq. Thanks for watching. Comment, subscribe, share, like, and peace. I'll see you in the next episode.